Hi guys, my name is Nick Smith. Welcome to this episode of Connect. Today we're going to be walking through a Zigbee demo, and we have Steve Dewant here from our R&D group who's going to take us through it. How's it going, Steve?
Doing great.
Great. Yeah. So before we get into the actual demo, can you give us a little high-level overview of what exactly Zigbee is?
Sure. So Zigbee is a wireless mesh protocol that's typically used in home automation and industrial applications.
Okay. Yeah, and I in one of our previous episodes, we had a Thread demo. So I know Zigbee and Thread are pretty similar, and Seth in our last episode laid out some of the differences there. So can you take me through what exactly I'm looking at here? What are the components of this demo?
Sure. So what we're looking at here is a sensor-to-cloud demo that we have set up. So we have two end devices, two Zigbee end devices. We have a Zigbee switch, and we have a Philips Hue light. Okay, these are our two Zigbee end devices.
Okay.
And these are going to be talking over a Zigbee wireless connection to our Zigbee network processor. Now, this is going to be acting as our Zigbee coordinator device. So these are talking through our Zigbee network.
Okay.
So now this Zigbee network processor will be talking over a serial USB connection to our BeagleBone Black here. Okay. On the BeagleBone Black, we have a Zigbee Linux gateway that's being hosted on here.
Okay.
And this gateway is responsible for communicating with the network processor and getting data, getting and sending data to our end devices. So basically, we're able to have full control of our Zigbee network through our Linux, standard Linux device.
Okay.
And now on here as well, we have a Node.js application running, a web client, a web application that will be connected to our Wi-Fi mobile hotspot here. So now this is talking to the BeagleBone Black again over a Wi-Fi connection. And now we also have our tablet here, our end device, that is able to access the web application running on the BeagleBone Black.
Okay.
So from here, you can see we have our Zigbee light and our Zigbee switch already connected.
Okay.
So from here, we can control the light from the mobile application, turning the light on and off, changing the hue, saturation level, etc. Now again, this is working with a standard Zigbee device.
Cool.
Now we also have a switch. What I'm going to do here is bind our switch to our light.
And can you explain the binding process and what that is really quick?
Sure. So really high level, we have a switch and we want to set up a bind or the ability to control the light from our switch.
Okay. So if it's like as if a user bought a light at a store, Home Depot or whatever, and bought a switch, they brought it home, they have to bind a switch to a certain light.
Yes.
Okay.
Exactly. Gotcha. And now we're going to be doing that again through our web application.
Okay.
So from here I'll set up the bind. The switch has now been bound to the light, and now from the switch I can physically toggle the Hue light.
Okay.
So what I'm doing is I'm pressing the side button to send a toggle command to the Hue light.
Very cool. Yeah, well, thank you. Thanks, Steve, for taking us through that demo today. Thank you guys for joining this episode of Connect. Don't forget to go to www.ti.com/Zigbee to get some more information. You can also tweet at me, @sensor2cloud, if you have any questions about the demo or suggestions for topics. Don't forget to join us next time. We're sitting down with an expert on the SimpleLink software and the robustness that can bring to your embedded development. Thanks, guys.
Thanks.